This morning, a former Catholic priest in central Pennsylvania is beginning a 16-year prison term. He was sentenced on Wednesday for molesting boys during missionary trips to Honduras. The priest, Joseph Mauricio, was one of several named in a damning report by a grand jury that was just released on Tuesday. It accused the Altoona Johnstown Diocese of ignoring or hiding clergy sex abuse for decades. Mark Rozzi is a Democratic state representative in Pennsylvania. He himself was abused by a priest when he was a boy, and he joins us from Harrisburg. Mark, good morning, and thank you for your time. This report said at least 50 priests and other church employees abused hundreds of children over 40 years, and that the bishops covered it up. What accountability can come out of this report?
There's really only one answer to that, and that we must reform the statute of limitations. We must eliminate the civil and criminal statutes, and we must open up a two-year window to give victims the ability to go to court and have their voices heard. Just like in this, in Johnstown, many of these victims will never be able to go to court because of the arbitrary statute of limitations here in Pennsylvania, and we need to change that.
Legal experts, I understand, say one of the reasons for limiting the number of years in which a victim can come forward, the so-called statute of limitations you're talking about, is that victims may not remember exactly what happened, the details, so many decades later. As a victim yourself, Mark, what would your response to that argument be?
That is just BS. That is a smokescreen. That is just another lie to stop victims from coming forward and telling their stories. Victims don't forget what happened to them. I remember every single day that I go into my bathroom and I go into my shower that I was raped by a priest. That doesn't change. I've talked to other victims, even one woman that was 75 years old who could recount her story of being raped at 15. Victims don't forget. We just want to have our voices heard. And there is some opposition to us coming forward, mainly from the Catholic Conference. They're the ones that are trying to silence not only victims of priest abuse, but victims across the board from all different types of child abuse.
Did you try to press charges against your abuser, Mark?
Unfortunately, I did not. By the time that I was able to come forward and talk about it, I was 39 years old. My second childhood friend had just committed suicide. And what people don't realize is that when I was sexually abused and raped, the statute of limitations for me in Pennsylvania were I only had 5 years to come forward criminally and 2 years to come forward civilly. Now, that's ridiculous. First of all, as a 13, 14-year-old, I didn't even know what a statute of limitation was. And how was I supposed to come forward by the age of 18? When I couldn't even talk about it till my second childhood friend killed himself, and that was when I was age 39. So I don't want to hear from the opponents to this type of legislation. They need to get out of the way, and we need to move forward with this to give victims their voice.
The Philadelphia Archdiocese went through this same thing. In 2005, your state also had the Jerry Sandusky sex abuse cases. Other states have amended the statute of limitation laws. Why hasn't your state? Where is the opposition coming from?
It is mainly the Catholic Conference and the Insurance Federation. The Catholic Conference is spending millions of dollars every year to silence victims. Up here in Harrisburg, they do everything they need to do, take out legislators, they take them golfing, the dinner. They do everything to make sure legislation do not move in the judiciary committees. It's just despicable to me that legislation isn't moving. And you're right. How many cases? We had three grand jury testimonies in Philadelphia. Cosby recently, the Boy Scouts, Sandusky. What will it take? But if you read this report in full from Johnstown, you'll know why the Catholic Conference spends millions of dollars every year to block legislation from coming forward.
And the report says that police and law enforcement were also sort of complicit, implying there was some sort of conspiracy that was wider than just the church. Is that how influential the Catholic Church still is in central Pennsylvania?
That, to me, is just unbelievable. Where else in this country or in this state, and I want to know, do you have a bishop picking the police chief? How could victims ever get justice in Johnstown? A victim comes forward to the police chief, and what do? They call the bishop and the monsignors to come in, say that they're going to take care of it, that they're going to, you know, send the priest to a rehab center where the rehab center is owned by the Catholic Church. So if the priest doesn't admit any guilt, they put him right back into the population where he can abuse 100 more kids. I'm actually going to be calling on the Attorney General of Pennsylvania to investigate every diocese in the state of Pennsylvania. We need to have an answer if this was rampant and if this is across our state. And from what I'm hearing from victims that are reaching out to me, this is.
So you have reason to believe that further investigation will uncover more cases of sexual abuse in other dioceses in your state?
Oh, absolutely. There's no doubt about it. I have had victims reach out to me from my own diocese, the Allentown diocese, the Pittsburgh diocese. In fact, a lot of cases from the Pittsburgh diocese. I don't know how they got unscathed, how we haven't investigated them yet. We need to do that. We need to go to every one of these places, open up the secret archives, and look and see what happened. We can't, you know, one thing we know is if we look at this information, we can correct things moving forward, but we need to hold these bishops and the institutions accountable for the crimes that they have committed and covered up.
Mark Rozzi, a state representative from Pennsylvania, thank you so much for sharing your story and for your time this morning.
Thank you, Stephanie.